How can you see into my eyes? My open doors leading you down into my core, where I become so
you're not going to replace the phone.
I mean, I can't replace this phone under the warranty.
And just why not?
Well, it appears your daughter's phone here has been dropped in water. We don't cover accidents.
And what makes you think it got wet? Oh.
Look, lady, that's just the way it is. If my daughter were a submarine commander like yours, I'd buy the extra replacement insurance.
How much is that going to be?
It's only $11.19 a month.
Look, how much for just a replacement phone?
Well, it's going to be a little bit more. It's $119 for a new phone. Not kidding. You think you want one?
Yeah. You take a check?
Gleefully. Thank you very much.
Well, there's nothing left for my birthday celebration today.
I'm sorry.
Looks like those shoes will have to wait. Guess I'm buying a phone for my daughter instead.
Well, happy birthday anyway.
Yeah. Gee. Thanks.
I've been believing in something so distant as if was human, and I've been denying this feeling of hopelessness in me, alone and lost in pain.
You don't look so good. It's my birthday, and all I have for company is you and $4 in my bank. $4.69. Wait,
You're blaming this on me? Do you see anyone else? Oh, I see. Feeling a little bitchy, are we? You should talk. Come on, let's go flying. The strength, the speed. You know you love it.
I just want to be me again.
Screw that. You just want to be me, and you know it.
I'm just tired of all the hiding.
Look, I know this is hard for you to understand. Let's just take it slow. There's a bar over there. Let's take a break. You, me, girls' night out. What do you say?
Okay, let's get hammered.
My tale begins on a cold, cloudy evening last January 18th. I had contacted a young budding PhD professor and a researcher in psychology from the University of Pennsylvania, Rashid Patel Jones. I thought that there was a paycheck in his story. Boy, was that an underestimation. Rather than spend hours on scientific mumbo-jumbo that would probably shoot right over my aching head, Dr. Jones insisted that it would be much easier to demonstrate his theory in the field. He suggested that we meet at 9 o'clock at a beat-up 50-year-old house converted into a bar and grill called O'Malley's. Run down O'Malley's, I slam my car door. The consummate professional writer. Is that what one looks like? I needed some money from somewhere. I needed to completely focus on Jones's work. Wow! Look at the major league yabbas on that chick. I thought as an attractive girl slithered by with her coat open, revealing a Ravage Me low-cut dress. Not that Ravage Me was a brand name or a designer, but maybe it should be. I better put a note of that in my get-rich-quick list to start a line of women's clothing with that name. Ravage Me. Now. What was that? Oh, yeah. Focus. Well, maybe I wasn't completely focused on Jones's project. After an uneventful drive to O'Malley's, I arrived right on time. Okay, a couple minutes. Okay, a half hour late. Hey, no one told me the place was ringed with defenses. Nasty old ladies and luscious women jumping out at you from everywhere. I pushed through the doors of O'Malley's promptly at 9:27 to be greeted by the stale smell of yesterday's spilled beer. And despite the dark light in the bar, I found Dr. Jones immediately. Compared to his short height, I seemed like a giant with my 6'2". Okay, 6 foot. Okay, 5'10" cyclist build. Okay, working on the cyclist part. Hey, I did own my own bike once, okay? It had training wheels. It was a while ago, but a bike nonetheless.
Glad you could make
so he greeted me with this endlessly pumping handshake that proved tough to break.
I'm so grateful that you could make it here.
I'm here.
I'm so glad to meet you finally.
Oh, right.
I've really been waiting to...
Yeah. What can I get you gents?
I'll have a Perrier.
Have you got on women's underwear?
Why... No?
Well, good, then we're even. Because I ain't got no pansy-ass frog water. And how about you, big spender?
You know I don't think I'm happy with my outfits.
Why ain't I surprised? I'll check back in a month or so. Maybe your big lottery check will come in by then. Why does God insist on testing such a sweet, gentle soul like me? Hey! Get off my bleeding bar, you moron!
There. Do you see them?
I looked around, not wanting to feel stupid or intimidated right away. I'd save that for later.
You want me to show you how to go? What exactly am I looking for, Professor?
Just look. Look, my friend, and tell me what you see.
Well, over there I see two guys. One of them trying to get inside of a closed door while the other one continuously slamming the men's room door in his face. Asshole. And then over there, you got that guy on that bar stool. He's trying to sit and he slides down. Dickhead.
Good, good. And look in the back room. Can you tell me what is happening there?
Well, I see about five guys. A few of them wearing antlers, and the guy's got a rifle. He's taking shit. Jesus, what is this? Freaking Hall of Morons?
Yes, yes. What else?
Well, the guy's a lousy shot. Jesus. Holy shit. I have to call the cops here. Somebody needs to call 911.
These men have been doing this for a long time. It's practically a tradition in this part of town. I doubt the police would even come. Now, would you say that is odd?
Odd? It's freaking unbelievable.
Yes. Now, can you describe these men?
Well, I mean, they look like they're in their mid-20s, early 30s.
Good. And what about the women?
I didn't see any. There are no freaking women here.
No, my friend, look over here.
Kaboom! There sat a luscious, long-haired blonde, early 30s. Her eyes suddenly flashed right at me, blue then green. Then her eyes flashed at me again.
My God, where did she?
Her mouth, they gave me a quick smile of acknowledgement. Both saying hello. This way to heaven.
My God, where did she come from?
Now, my friend, let's not forget we are men of science here to promote a great discovery.
Yes, we are.
My friend, you must be careful. A woman like that could fry you like an insect. Believe me, I know.
That she could.
Anyways, what's your point?
Do you see that woman sitting over there? Now, what's wrong with this picture?
Absolutely nothing, Doc. Nothing at all.
Wrong. Look again. Do you not find her attractive?
Yeah.
I do as well. And yet, there she sits, all alone. A room full of drunken young men, and there, a desirable young female with five empty bottles of light beer in front of her, and yet she sits alone. How can this be?
You got a point. I can fix that.
No. We are conducting a scientific experiment here, and you must not alter the controlled conditions we have here. Sit down, my friend. And I will tell you what it is that you are really seeing. The forces that are at work in this place.
Yeah.
Now, Do you see this map here with all the numbered locations on it? This map of Scranton, Pennsylvania. Now, all these small numbers show the radiation levels of the soil samples that I have taken.
Yeah.
In fact, these show the readings on the epsilon radiation scale.
Yeah, epsilon.
I see that you are puzzled, my friend.
Yes.
Not really. The whole time he spoke, I was checking out the blonde. But I did get something about radiation samples and epsilon ray, whatever the heck that was. Focus. Focus.
Yeah.
Focus was a distant memory.
Right.
Now I wish I had really been listening that night. But the view. Oh my, the view.
Yeah. As I was saying, epsilon radiation is a rarely monitored type of radiation whose properties and frequencies are still largely unknown. Now, as you can see from my readings, they're highest here at the center, and they get lower and lower as you go outside the city.
Okay.
And just where do you think the point is with the highest recorded epsilon radiation? Right here, here in the center, here, and here is O'Malley's bar where we sit at this very moment.
All right, so what exactly do you think is happening here, Doc?
During that time period, this entire area outlined on my map was exposed to massive amounts of epsilon radiation.
Ah.
And that left the soil contaminated for years. Mm. All the young men born during that time period show reduced functionality disorder, RFD.
RFD?
Yes, yeah. RFD. As you can see, they are all morons. Their judgment and ability to react to external stimuli has been traumatically impaired. How else can you explain young, prime of their lives men, unable to even notice a woman like that sitting over there, let alone approaching her?
So, what you're saying is that this radiation made all the men born in this town have RFD.
Yes, yes. But that's only part of it. The epsilon radiation gave some of the women superpowers. It reacted with them in the opposite way, based on the chemical makeup of estrogen. So, you end up with women like that one over there, on the other end of the scale, with heightened senses and abilities.
What you're saying is she's totally unsatisfied.
Yes, that may well be true. I mean, how could she be by men such as these?
Then years of being a cynic crept into me.
Super women. I mean, come on. Really? I mean,
proof, is it, huh? Proof is it you want, Mr. Doubting Thomas? Well, try this one on for size, mister. Try this puppy on for size.
All right. What do we got here?
Well, do you see the ear on that picture?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
I do.
Do you see all the medals around their necks?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that Russian women's team won 67.3% of all the medals in the Olympics that year. And they are all gold. Now, do you see the woman in this video?
I see him.
This is the most famous Russian celebrity from 1972 to 1976, Olga Sechua.
Okay.
She was their top model, their top movie star, their record-holding cosmonaut, and a damn fine cook, too.
Okay. Whoa! Did you see that?
See what?
Her eyes! Her eyes! Did you see what her eyes just did?
Oh, yes. Olga's hazel eyes were her trademark. Lovely, don't you think?
Hazel? Hazel, my ass! Her eyes are gray! And didn't you not see them explode from green to blue?
There was no explosion, my friend. That's probably because this is very old film turned digital. Everyone knows about Olga's hazel eyes. I see that you are intrigued.
Okay, but how do these events that happen in Russia, I mean, how do they relate to what's happening here in Scranton?
Well, Guess what building is just behind this bar with the highest radiation level that I recorded?
It's a beer warehouse. I mean, what does that have to do with anything?
Oh, it's a beer warehouse today. But guess what it was between 1967 and 1989, the year the Cold War ended? It was the Miles Research Corporation, now known through freedom of information releases to be a front for the CIA, their behavioral sciences section. Now how's that for your Cold War mind-altering research shit?
Okay, come on. So you think that the Miles Research, CIA, whatever, they have to do something with keeping up with these Russian athletes?
Yes, they had to be if they ever wanted to win another gold medal in the Olympics. I mean, just think about it. Russia's perfect weapon. They would use the Epsilon radiation on the armies in Western Europe and turn them into morons, just as likely to shoot each other, just like these assholes over here. Not to mention, they wouldn't be able to reproduce because they wouldn't be able to see a woman, let alone know what to do with her. And to make things worse, their women would then be the best at everything. Huh. America would lose its biggest export, Hollywood movies. Russian superwomen would dominate the box office.
Huh.
And not to mention the complete collapse of the American porn industry. It would be an economic disaster. The Russians would just walk through our defenses and we would be unable to stop them for at least like two half-lives of the Epsilon radiation or about 30 years. Well, just look at what's happened to Scranton since the Epsilon radiation was released. There's been an economic decline, population has dropped, birth rates have dropped, alcoholism is on the rise, the mafia has moved in and taken control. This was the model of what Russia had planned for the entire United States. First, they would have targeted Western Europe, and then mainland USA. But something went terribly wrong. Here in the US, the effects of the Epsilon radiation have only affected Scranton. But in Russia, they had wide-ranging effects through the entire country. I mean, look what's happened over there. The economy went bankrupt and they lost the Cold War.
Mm-hmm.
They've had drop in population
right.
and birth rates.
That's right.
They've got high alcoholism.
Mm-hmm.
The mafia is running the country.
Okay.
I mean, don't you see the parallel connections here?
Mm.
Do you still think that a cowboy president, Ronald Reagan, bankrupted Russia and won the Cold War? Or was it the result of all of their research and Epsilon radiation gone out of control, just like Chernobyl?
What was the third choice?
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright, so you're definitely on something here, Doc. You know, I just can't write about a theory.
No. This is just the introduction. The wetting of your whistle, so to speak. We have the RFDs as evidence. What we need is the other half of the equation, the superwoman. Once we have proof of that, then we can go public with this puppy. Mm. I need your help with that. Now, Dmitry is in Russia trying to find Olga Sechuov and the rest of that Russian Olympic team. He's also having a lot of luck with super women in the Russian personal ads. You know what I mean? Anyway, just yesterday he told me that he's found the small town where he believes Olga is in hiding. Now, you and I need to find the Olga Sechuov of Scranton, Pennsylvania. Once we do that and verify her powers, then we go on to fame, to riches, to the Nobel Prize, and maybe even TV talk shows.
Hmm. You got a deal, Doc.
Oh, you won't be sorry, I'm promising you that.
Hmm. Right. Okay.
Yeah. I remembered how excited Jones was to have converted someone to his theory. You could feel the energy oozing out of him. Or maybe it was just Curry. I too felt the excitement of belonging to something that transcended the day-to-day. I just hoped it was a paycheck and it's somewhere.
Hey, where are you guys going?
I feel like an ass now. But I couldn't say a word to her. I think Jones even drooled a little. Mr. Macho. I had wanted so badly to approach her, but now, in her presence, I was reduced to jello. Blind jello, no less. You know, the kind that nobody likes. I had no explanation for the effect that she had on us, other than to say, you had to be there. We didn't stop at her table, but continued out the two sets of doors to the streets in silence with stupid grins on our faces.
Thank you once again, my friend.
Thank you.
I'll be in touch once I plan the next step of our search for the Scranton Superwoman.
Right.
I'm sure the answer is in here somewhere. Now, if you will excuse me, in a town like this, where the men wouldn't know a woman even if she was sitting on their face, even a guy like me can get lucky.
I love the sound of that.
Research. Lots of research.
Research. Lots of fun.
I remember I was glad for him. Able to move on with the night. No, but for me, I felt disturbed. Like I was suddenly aware of a different world that I now lived in.
Oh, damn, the doc is right. This town is full of morons. Jesus.
No.
I know you! Oh, I do, I do.
No, it's not me.
You know what? You know what? You're an asshole! That's what!
Stupid as it may seem now, I expected her to still be there. One of her empty light beer bottles and sniffed it like I was some sort of bloodhound or freaking DNA machine. She left nothing else except a 20 for a tip next to an empty bottle. I stood and looked at the 20, knowing it would make good company for the empty wallet that I had.
If you're looking for some place to drink, I'd recommend someplace other than here. One of those guys back there's getting pretty good. Might actually hit something, if you know what I mean.
Right. Thanks for the tip. Listen, the woman that was sitting here, did you happen to get a look at her? Is she a regular? Do you know her name?
Not hardly. I might be an old fart, but my heart's still ticking. Oh, thanks. I'd remember a bird like her.
Huh. So, did you happen to get a look at her eyes?
Listen, I said I was old. I didn't say I was dead. It's not that they told me. I done brought her a table full of beers. You think I didn't notice them eyes?
So you saw them?
What, am I blind now too? Of course I saw them. Ain't seen hazel eyes like that since I was a young man.
Right, right. Hey, thanks a lot.
But when the old man grabbed my arm, I was expecting fatherly advice.
If I ever catch you trying to cop one of me tips again, you'll find yourself with a bottle up your arse.
Hazel eyes my ass, I muttered. Fine way to treat an investigative journalist.
Huh?